Hi everyone, and welcome to Organic Chemistry on YouTube. Today we'll be talking about Zaitsev and Hoffman alkenes, their stabilities, as well as elimination reactions that can lead to both of those products. So first of all, alkene stability is determined by the substitution pattern. More substituted alkenes are considered to be Zaitsev alkenes. Those alkenes that are less substituted are considered to be Hoffman alkenes. So which base is used in an elimination reaction is really important for favoring the Zaitsev or the Hoffman product, depending on the substrate and the type of base. The main difference between the bases are bulky versus small. An example of a bulky base is tert butoxide. An example of a small base is sodium hydroxide. And these types of elimination questions are a really interesting class of reactions where kinetics can determine the reactivity instead of the thermodynamics. Okay, so let's consider this reaction involving a secondary alkyl bromide in the presence of a strong base, tert butoxide, and you get a mixture of products. You have the major product, which is the Hoffman product, and the minor product, which is the Zaitsev product. If we take a quick look at these two, the minor product is actually the more substituted alkene, and the major product is the less substituted alkene. This might be a little confusing because you would think that the Zaitsev product, the one that's the most substituted, the most stable, would be the preferred product, and usually it is. But if the base is too large, this can lead to the Hoffman product being favored, as we show in this reaction. Let me show you that reaction mechanism. So the base is this molecule here, tert butoxide, and it has two choices when deprotonating this molecule. It can take this hydrogen that's here in green, or it can take one of these hydrogens, which are shown here in black. If the tert butoxide deprotonates the green hydrogen, what it can do is deprotonate the hydrogen, move the electrons onto the hydrocarbon framework, and then kick out the bromine to afford the Zaitsev product. So this one goes directly to Zaitsev. Try writing the reaction mechanism going to the Hoffman product, in this case, the major product. You can pause the video and return once you've written out a mechanism. Now, the same base can deprotonate one of these black hydrogens, and it can kick out that bromine just the same. And now this will lead to the Hoffman product. So why is this happening? Let's consider some important features of this reaction. So first of all, tert butoxide is a bulky base. And when we consider the two possible hydrogens, the green hydrogen and one of the black hydrogens, there's a very different steric environment in this reaction. Those hydrogens that are shown in black are at the end of the molecule. There's a whole lot of surface area by which that strong base can come in and deprotonate this hydrogen. In contrast, the same bulky base, if it's trying to get into the space where it can deprotonate the green hydrogen, this has a much more sterically crowded environment. And the transition state energy for this process will be a lot higher for the green hydrogen than that for the black. So since the reaction involving the less sterically encumbered hydrogen is lower, that means that reaction is going to be notably faster than the reaction involving the green hydrogen. So the steric effects and the transition states are controlling the reaction rates and ultimately the product ratios. So finally, the Zaitsev product will always be favored unless the steric effects become unfavorable in the transition state, as we see in this. Finally, let's talk about some questions you might ask in office hour. What makes a base bulky? What is there a dividing line? Are there a list of bulky bases that you should memorize or learn? Two, how does a bulky base increase the activation energy? Perhaps your instructor can draw this out on the board in 3D or show it using a computer program. And finally, can there be a tie for Zaitsev versus Hoffman products? So with that's been Organic Chemistry in 5 minutes or less. Thanks very much for tuning in.